right, so repairs. One of the things that people get confused a lot, so especially like you've been hearing repairs, and not necessarily had the session to explain what that is that I personally find, we did inherit that from Cassandra, but I personally find the term not the best, because what you tend to think is that there is something wrong with my database, and then it needs to be repaired. So the first thing, like when you run repair, that doesn't mean there is something wrong with the database. More than that, there is only a class of, it does fix something, but there is only a class of issues that are fixed by repair. So in part because of the name, one of the things that we very commonly see is people saying, well, my database is slow, I'll run a repair to see if it gets faster. It won't get faster because that's not the things that repairs are designed to do. Or maybe, well, something happened and whatever, I think it's wrong, and then should I run a repair? The logs are saying that I'm out of memory. I'll run a repair to repair that. Once more, repair will not do this for you. So what is it exactly that repair? If that's not what repairs are, what are they? So whenever there is a write, so this is the model, you're probably seeing this in the classes in which data modeling and the basic architecture of Scylla was being discussed. Every time there is a write, and this is also something that a lot of people get it wrong, every replica, there is a replica for that key, will receive that write. So when you write something with consistency level 1, that does not mean that we are only writing to one replica. We are always writing to every replica. So you have replication factor of 3 in one data center, replication factor of 3 in other data center. We're going to write to all 6 replicas for that key, always. So there is no case in which Scylla will say, oh, I'm not going to write to that node. If the node is down, I cannot write to that node, but we'll always try to write to those nodes. But then there is the consistency level. What the consistency levels say is how many replicas have to respond before I consider this write successful. And the consequence of that is that I cannot tell anything about what happened in the other replicas. I don't know. Maybe the write was successful. Maybe it was not successful. So there isn't something I can say. The state really is unknown. So if you write with quorums, which is our local quorums, which is how most people write, usually you're going to have 2 replicas that are guaranteed to have this piece of data. Why? Because it returned, the write returned a success. Then you mean, sure, yeah, my data is there. But there is nothing you can say about the third replica. Most of the time, it's just fine because your network is without issues, but maybe you had a network issue. Maybe the node was overloaded. It didn't reply. You don't know. Then reads, so reads are different. So this is writes. Reads are different. Reads will try to be effective and efficient. So if you say, I will read with consistency level 1, that only means, so there are exceptions of that, like probabilistic, we'll discuss that, but that only means that we will try a single replica, because I want my reads to be as fast as possible. So you ask me for a consistency level 1 or local 1, I'm only going to touch one replica. What happens if I wrote with a quorum? So I have a scenario with 3 nodes, and then I have another node that doesn't have the, I wrote with a quorum, 2 nodes have the data, and then what happens if I read with local 1 or 1? Like anything can happen. Maybe I hit one of the replicas that has the data. I'm fine. I read the most up-to-date data. Maybe I read one of the replicas that didn't return, were not part of that quorum, but he has the data anyway, because most of the time he will. Then my data will be correct. But it could also be that I will hit the replica that happens not to have the write. Doesn't have that data, or it has older data for their key. In that case, this replica will return older or inexisting data. This is what repairs are designed to fix. So repairs are designed to make sure that all replicas have the same copy of the data. If you have an overwrite, maybe overwrite scenario, maybe all replicas have data, but the data in one of them is newer, right? And then repair will make sure that everybody has the most up-to-date copy. Is this a problem to read stale data or to read no data where you expect data? I don't know. this is something that your application has to tell me. Like, if you cannot ever tolerate that, there is a way to do it, which is you write with quorum, you read with quorum, then you always consulting a majority. It's fine. Maybe you don't care if you read stale data for a while because your application tolerates that. Then you can play with the consistency level. One way or another, repair is the tool that is going to make sure that all replicas are up to date, right? So in this example here, I have replication factor of 3 per data center, right? So I have 2 data centers, and I am writing with local quorum. Local quorum, what does that mean? I want a majority of the nodes in this data center to reply, and then I'll consider the write successful. So in the first data center, the data center that in which you sent the write, 2 nodes are guaranteed to have the data because the local quorum returns success. I don't know which 2, but 2 of them have the data. There's another node, you can't say anything about it. Maybe it has the data, maybe it doesn't. And the second data center, maybe it has the data, maybe it doesn't. And only after repair, they're all gonna have the same thing. Now there are 3 types of repair. There's people call it repair, but in reality there are 3 different processes that have repair in their name. The first of them is synchronous read repair. Synchronous read repair, as the name says, it happens at read time. So let's say that's why, by the way, if you read and write with quorum, you always have the most up-to-date data. Because during a read, if I contact 2 replicas, so in a replication factor of 3 case, my quorum reads will contact 2 replicas. If I contact 2 replicas or 3 replicas or 4 or however many I contact, and at that time, I notice that there are mismatch between them, I fix it and then I return it back to you. So synchronous read repair, because it happens synchronously in the read path. So again, once more, if you read this data with quorum, that was written with quorum, even if you happen to hit a node that has the data and a node that doesn't have the data, at that point, they will both have the data because synchronous read repair will have fixed it. There's another situation, so situation number 2, in which synchronous read repairs happen. And this is whenever I roll the dice. It's obviously not a physical dice, but there is a chance of 1%, if I'm not mistaken. And I do this one, the second one, then I'll talk to all replicas. So chance of 1%. And then you can configure, we're not going into how you configure it, but in the table properties, you can configure the chance of this repair happening across data centers, and you can configure the chance of this repair happening within the data center, so you can make it more often that it happens within the data center, and you can make it less frequent that it runs cross data center. The default is 0 for cross data centers, so that doesn't ever happen across data centers. But let's say in 1% of your reads, I would just say, well, this read, I just decided that I will go read all replicas. So what it does is I roll the die, and it tells me don't do it. Then I don't do it. I just use the normal path. If I see a difference, I'll fix it. If I don't, I'm not going to do anything, and I'll just return to you. But for 1% or however number of the reads, I roll the die. I say, okay, for this one, I will fix it. And then I go read all the replicas in the local data center. And if there is no difference, even better, if there is any difference at that point, I'll fix it. However, the third one is the asynchronous one. We'll talk later. When most people are talking about repairs, they're not talking about those 2 repairs. A lot of people don't even know those things exist because they're happening internally to the database. Like the operator doesn't need to be involved. There's nothing you have to do. I mean, the read comes to you and it's already correct. When you hear the word repair, most of the time people are talking about asynchronous repair, which is the one that you gotta go and do and initiate and do something. What is it that this repair does, asynchronous repair? So from now on, when I say repair, I mean asynchronous repair. Because we don't know where the differences are, so it could be that all keys are correct, it could be that some keys are incorrect, it could be that 1% of the keys are incorrect, it could be that 10% of the keys are incorrect, we have no idea. So the only way to do it is to scan your entire database, compare checksums between or among all of the replicas if you have more than 2, and then do the same thing. If it's wrong or stale or invalid or old, I'll fix it. If not, I'll move to the next one. And the reason it's called asynchronous is not because you do it as the operator. It's because the read path is not affected by this, right? So the reads are happening, and they don't care. I mean, the reads don't change. The way the reads happen don't change because you're running asynchronous repair. But in the background, you have this process that is scanning the database, talking to all of the replicas, and comparing checksums. And every time there is a mismatch in the checksum, I know that there is data in there that one of the replicas don't have or have an older version or et cetera. And at that point, I'll fix it. Do I need to run repairs? That's a question we hear a lot. And the answer is yes. So the simple answer is yes, you do. Why? For those reasons we discussed. I mean, actually, this is one valid case where you need to be in a very bad state for this to become really noticeable. But it could even help. It can happen to help you with performance if you have a lot of mismatches that you would have to otherwise fix at read time. But the most important thing to do is make sure that all of your data is all the replicas are seeing the same data. However, do I really need to run repairs? Because some people don't like doing it because maybe I don't want to add the repair load into the cluster or whatever. So there are scenarios in which you don't need to run repair, and we'll discuss them briefly. I mean, I don't plan to delve too much into them. The first one is if you really don't care about consistency of your data. That's the trivial one. Like, a lot of applications really don't care. There are especially like a complex machine learning applications. If you have a little bit of data that happens to be wrong, like nothing bad is going to happen. So I decide not to run repair. That's fine. If you run a single data center, it is safe to skip repair if the consistency level for reads plus the consistency level for writes is bigger than the replication factor. Classical example, quorum plus quorum, which is always by definition bigger. Why? Because of what we just described, like, we're always going to be finding a group of two or a majority, and they will return the right data. If there's no deletes, we'll talk about that. If you have deletes, this breaks. Whenever you have deletes or TTL, TTLs are deletes. They're just deletes that you didn't have to do because they were done for you. But if you have deletes or TTLs, you cannot skip your repairs. I'll talk about why later. But if you don't have deletes, if you don't have TTLs, and you always doing a majority write plus majority read, it's fine. Multi-data center, I'll just skip